Big parts of Germany's forests used to look like this. But now they look like this. In just a couple of years, this decades-old forest has become unrecognizable. The same thing is happening in many parts of Germany, Europe and North America.
Mein Herz tut jeden Tag weh, wenn ich das sehe.
Sie können in Mitteleuropa nirgends so Klimakrise erleben, wie das hier im Harz ist, ja?
But this isn't your typical the planet is dying story. This could actually be good news.
But to understand why, let's backtrack a little bit, or maybe more than a little bit, to the end of World War II. A lot of the world is in ruins and needs to be rebuilt. The Allied forces understandably want reparations from Germany, but it's broke. So they agree that the country will pay partly in materials, for example, timber. Lots of timber, according to some estimates, equivalent to 10% of the country's forests. So now foresters need to replant big areas ASAP to rebuild Germany itself. And which tree did they choose? Mostly the spruce, which, looking back, was maybe not the best decision. But at that time, it seemed like a good idea. To find out why, we're driving to Thuringia, in the center of Germany, to meet Fanny Hurtig, a forester.
Die Fichte ist schnellwüchsig, sie bringt ein häufig gerades und qualitativ hochwertiges Holz, was sich dann eben auch gut durch die Sägewerke verarbeiten lässt, zu Möbeln, zu Fußböden fürs Papier etc. Also sie ist eigentlich sehr weiträumig einsetzbar.
That's why it's also a very lucrative tree. German foresters planted vast areas with them, in straight rows that make it easier to get in and harvest. This practice didn't only start after the Second World War. People had been planting evergreen trees for centuries, but the post-war shortage really kicked off the era of extreme monocultures.
This is what a lot of Germany's forests look like. All the same tree, not a lot happening on the ground. It's kind of boring, really.
Spruces are the most common tree in Germany and make up over a quarter of all forests. But that is changing rapidly, because what made this monoculture so profitable is also what made it so vulnerable. Forests around the world are suffering from more intense and frequent droughts, wildfires and storms, weakening entire ecosystems. And Germany is no exception.
Nun war dieser Sturm 2018 und daraufhin dann eigentlich 3, 4, 5 Trockenjahre, die das Feinwurzelsystem der Fichte so geschädigt haben, dass sie eigentlich keine Kraft mehr hat, genügend Wasser aus dem Boden zu bringen.
The longer summers due to climate change mean the forests are too dry and the trees thirsty. Especially spruce trees. They comparatively need a lot of water, but their root system is quite shallow, so they can't access reservoirs deeper down. On top of that, many spruces were planted at much lower elevations than they are native to, so they are not adapted to these warmer, drier surroundings. Meaning that if the surface dries out, which has happened a lot recently, it becomes a big problem. While that's not the best news for the trees or for humans, there is one little creature that loves what's happening right now. Enter the bark beetle. This tiny little insect has been munching its way through many of Germany's and Europe's forests. The bark beetle, of course, loves the bark. It bores holes into the tree and then releases pheromones to draw a mate inside. There, they reproduce and lay eggs. These tunnels are called Rammelkammer, which directly translates to sex chamber.
Ein Paar hat früher immer so 1 bis 2 Bruten gehabt. Jetzt mittlerweile sind wir bei 3 bis 4 Generationen. Ein Pärchen kann bis zu 100.000 Nachkommen erzeugen.
In einem Jahr?
In einem Jahr. Es ist eine wahnsinnig große Zahl, ja.
Deswegen ist es auch einfach...
Genau, explosionsartig, ja. Breitet sich das aus.
Wow.
A healthy tree usually produces resin to seal up the holes and to protect itself from the beetles. But thirsty, weak trees cannot. That's why the bark beetle is having a feast.
Also vor 5 Jahren war die Fläche noch voll bewaldet. Wenn wir jetzt heute hier stehen und die Fläche ist vielleicht letztes Jahr befallen gewesen, kann durchaus dieses Jahr diese Fläche innerhalb von weniger Wochen auch noch befallen sein.
The beetles eat away layers that transport nutrients and water. The spruces then die of thirst and malnutrition.
Das dauert keine Wochen, also wenige Wochen. Und dann ist der Baum wirklich mit Absterbeerscheinung, sodass es auch mit Wasser oder sonstigen nicht mehr zu regenerieren ist.
The forestry has set up traps to monitor the scale of the infestation.
Also wir haben jetzt hier 50 Milliliter. Ein Milliliter entspricht 40 Käfern. Das sind jetzt 2000 Käfer in dieser Falle. Und wir sehen, die Falle ist komplett voll.
The beetle is steadily spreading across Europe. And the hotter it gets, the more beetles will breed. What a full-scale infestation looks like can be seen in Bark Beetle Central, which is the Harz National Park in the middle of Germany, where we're headed.
Wow. All of that is just completely gone. That looks horrible, actually. It makes me really sad.
Here, about 90% of all spruces are dead. The bark beetle has come, eaten, and gone, leaving behind a region that is, quite frankly, shocking to look at. We're meeting Roland Pietsch, the head of the Harz National Park.
Seit 2014 haben wir hier im Oberharz auch schon wirklich Dürren. Und die Landschaft hat sich insofern geändert, dass die Fichten halt großräumig tatsächlich zum Teil komplett abgestorben sind.
The Harz region is hit so hard because it had a very big concentration of spruces. But for Peach and many others, this post-apocalyptic looking scenario isn't a disaster, quite the opposite. For him, the bark beetle isn't the villain. It's actually a blessing in disguise.
Die Frage ist ja, was passiert hier? Und was hier passiert, die Eulenfichten sind weg, ja? Und hier kommt jetzt der Wald, der hier hingehört. Wenn das grün ist und Sie sehen, was hier für eine Kraft, was für ein Leben drin, finde ich das schön. Ich finde das hier super toll und super spannend.
The park cut down a section of the forest as a safety barrier so that the beetle will have a harder time spreading into neighboring forests. But apart from that, the national park decided to let nature be nature and did not fight the bark beetle. And nature is indeed doing its thing.
Als ich jetzt vor 2021, also vor gut 2,5 Jahren hierher gekommen bin, da waren halt viele Bestände wirklich noch, die sahen tot aus. Ja. Aber das dauert 2-3 Jahre und dann haben sie dort das Leben wieder. Ja. Dann kommen Gräser, Kräuter, wie man es hier sehen kann.
Different areas of the national park are treated differently. Some parts where trees are springing up on their own are left to their own devices. Like this area that died off about 6 years ago.
Da, wo großflächig frei ist, kommen erst die Pionierbaumarten an, die Samen haben, die entweder durch Vögel oder Wind weit verbreitet und schnell verbreitet, auch in sehr großer Zeit produziert werden. Wenn Sie hier durchgehen, werden Sie in 10 bis 20 Jahren das Gefühl haben, Sie stehen in einem Wald.
Some parts need a little bit of help, meaning formerly native species that were displaced by the spruce monocultures are being planted.
Wir haben gepflanzt, weil der Mensch ungeduldig ist. Die Buche hat schwere Samen. Man hätte auch mehrere tausend Jahre warten können, aber man hat sich dagegen entschieden und ich finde, das ist eine gute Entscheidung.
The dead trees provide a habitat for insects. They also give shade and keep moisture locked in. Fungi help decompose the wood.
Oh, ja. Wow. Ein richtiger Schwamm.
Ein richtiger Schwamm, ne? Ja. Also richtig Wasser drin.
Dead trees release CO2 while decaying, which means overall less CO2 is sequestered by these forests. But the hope is that the new trees will compensate for that in the long term. But that's just one part of the story. The national park is a protected area that cannot be used to produce timber anymore. But only around 3% of all forests in Germany is protected. The rest is governed by public or private foresters, for example, to produce timber. And we'll probably be using more of it, since wood can be a very sustainable and renewable building material. Managed and grown by foresters, like back in Thuringia. They need to take a different approach to the bark beetle. The trees are checked for infestation regularly. Once an infestation is found, the trees are marked. Then they are chopped down and removed as soon as possible to halt the spread of the beetle. Leaving behind vast areas of prematurely felled trees. But also here, it's not seen as the catastrophe it may look like at first.
Es ist auch eine Chance, dass man eben jetzt Flächen strukturierter aufbaut und mit ganz anderen Baumarten einfach nochmal auch experimentiert und ganz andere Baumarten, wenn es hierher passt, auch hier mit reinbringt.
To prevent something like this from happening again, the approach here is to not only bet on one tree, but on a variety of trees.
Bei Aktien im Portfolio versucht man ja auch zu streuen, um nicht zu rutschen. Und genauso was versuchen wir im Mischwald auch.
This is Nico Frischbier, a scientist trying to identify the forest of the future. Here are some of the candidates. First are the OGs. Beech, oak, and sycamore trees are adapted to lower elevations. They can survive with less water because their root systems are deeper. But they grow much slower than spruces. Oaks take between 120 and 300 years to be harvestable. Second are the newcomers, like the Douglas fir. Native to North America, Douglas firs can also handle more heat and droughts. They grow quite fast and their wood is hard and of good quality. This type of fir is also more resistant to pests and storms than spruces. These are currently seen as good candidates. But if we continue to heat up the planet, we will need to mix in some wild cards. To find out which ones may be suitable, the Thuringian Forestry has been conducting a now over 10-year-old experiment in the driest region of the forest. The trees come from warmer climates, but are alpine trees, because if they want to survive here, they need to be able to handle not just drought, but also frost. So enter the southern bells. First off, the Turkish fir, which can thrive in very dry conditions and can stand in exposed areas. Its wood is also straight and similar to the spruce, but it's quite hard to plant successfully and also grows slowly. The Oriental beech is native to southeastern Europe and the Caucasus region. It is a broadleaf tree which is similar to other domestic beech trees. Its speciality is that it's super flexible and can adapt well to extreme weather. The rare Lebanese cedar grows quite fast, but is also hard to plant. And there are first signs the bark beetle likes this tree too.
Also es ist aufwendiger, schon mal, weil man sich mit mehreren Baumarten im Mischbestand beschäftigen muss. Die Bäume haben unterschiedliches Risiko, die haben unterschiedliche Kosten. Also es ist tatsächlich aufwendiger bis hin zur Vermarktung von Holz oder anderen Produkten. Aber aus unserer Sicht lohnt es sich, weil man eben das Risiko reduziert. Also man hat vielleicht mehr Ausgaben und einen geringeren Ertrag. Der kommt aber weniger risikobehaftet tatsächlich beim Waldbesitzer an.
This type of forestry, as well as the national parks approach, shows where a lot of international forests could be heading.
Es ist ja jetzt auch eine Chance, diesen Klimawandel oder den Waldumbau, den wir eigentlich sehr langsam einleiten sonst, eben etwas zügiger voranzubringen.
Das ist aus dem Aspekten Klimakrise, Widerstandsfähigkeit gut. Das ist für die Artenvielfalt gut.
The idea of cultivating a long-lasting mixed forest isn't new. It's just that in times of crisis, the quickest and easiest solution was chosen. These vast areas of dead trees are not the end of the forest. It's just the end of the forest as we know it here. Straight rows, tidy, fast-growing trees for profit. Even though it might look tragic, a new, better forest is already starting to grow. One that is more resilient than what we created before. And one that will hopefully weather and adapt to whatever is going to happen in the coming decades.
Thanks for watching. For more videos like this, subscribe. We post videos every Friday.